Hey guys, Tori here again, getting ready to, I'm in the process of stretching two, maybe three rooms of carpet, depending on if time will allow. So we're going to, for sure, going to stretch two rooms of carpet, and I'm going to finish out a doorway. So where I'm out in, where am I at?
Taylor.
Kind of outside of Taylor, out in Georgetown, or Williamson County, sort of, kind of, out in the country. Anyway, let me turn the camera around, we'll take a look. Alright, I've got the stretchers here already pulling here on this room. And every once in a while somebody will say, why don't you use a conventional power stretcher? It's for reasons just like what you see here. What I can do with the mini stretchers are far better than what I would have to do moving the bed and everything else with those. Anyway, over here I'm still trying to get a little wrinkle pulled out of here. There's one right here I'm trying to get. I've pulled it one time so far, and I believe there is one little bit of a wrinkle left here. And the wild card here is whether or not I'm going to have to cut and seam that. I don't know. Hopefully I won't, but if I do, I do. All right, I'm going to go down here. This is the doorway that I'm going to finish out right here. I'm going to use tack strip and some Z-bar and wrap it around here, and I'm gonna do this room here. I've already moved the bed around. I'm gonna stretch it toward the window, so I've already placed the bed in the middle and moved all of this other furniture around the outside, so I can pull up the carpet on three walls here and get a stretch. And the bed is light enough that I can stretch the carpet without moving the bed. So gonna do this room next. I'm gonna finish up with the doorway, and the wild card here is whether or not there's time and whether or not we feel like it. We may opt to do this room here, but what's going on in this room? Hello, doggy. This room here, this guy would have to move right here. Anyway, okay, you stay right there. Bye bye. All right, I'm gonna move the stretchers around and pull the room again, and I'll show you shortly what it did. All right, I'm getting ready to start in here. We'll go back and look at what I just finished up in there. You've got a legitimate wrinkle here, and you've got some furniture depression here. Let's see if it probably goes. Yeah, it does go the whole way under the bed. Got another one here, and I'm going to use, it's not necessary to use four carpet stretchers on a room this size, but if you got them, may as well. That's where I'm at with all that. All right, let's go over here and look at what I just did. I didn't get a whole lot off of the room. I thought I would probably get more, but I didn't. This is what was taken off at the end of it all there. So what's it, maybe half an inch or so. It all turned out real well. Everything stretched out, and I didn't have to cut the seam in the door. It moved over this far, so that's why I thought I would probably do this last, because I didn't know how much was going to move out. And I have to try to find a stopping place. I'll stretch this side a little bit as well, but not enough that I'm going to want to stretch the entire hallway, because it doesn't need it. All right, well, I'm gonna pull up the carpet in here and put the stretchers down, and I'll update the video then. I'm having a conversation with the homeowner, so the video is gonna lack a little bit, but at any rate, I'll check in shortly. Carpet has been, it's been stretched twice now. I moved the stretchers one time and did an additional stretch on it. Once was enough, but I figured why not. Go ahead and stretch it really tight here. Make sure. Yeah, I don't know what you guys are seeing, but they're definitely flat under there. I want to show this before I kick everything into place. I'll show when I get everything stretched in and cut off here in a minute. Anyway, wanted to catch up the video just a little bit here to show some progress. I will be checking back in again shortly, so hang on. All right, this room's all done. This was what wound up getting cut off. I didn't think that you would get that much off a room this size, but didn't tighten now. All right, now I'm gonna go out and finish out the doorway, so I'll show some footage out there next. All right, I was going too fast here. I'm about to lift this out here. I cut the carpet off. What I did was I split the difference in the seam in the doorway here, and I managed to get the carpet tape to peel off pretty well. So what I did was I in order to get them to stick really well, I never count on the nails working, so I always drill pilot holes and drop in 1-inch concrete nail anchors. So I put that all in here, and I had to add a little piece of pad here, otherwise there'd be a divot in it. So pull this back, the Z-bar. Now I'm going to tuck it all in, get it real tight, and then hammer it down. And that will be the end of that. So I'll show the conclusion here in just a minute. All right. Got this finished up now. And generally the way I do this is I take the carpet and I tuck it with a tucker, with a stair tool, as far under there as I can. And I'll generally hold it under there with my left hand. And very carefully, I won't use the hammer. I don't use the hammer on it. I use this tool here, and I hit it really hard, and I feel like it gets it mashed closer to the concrete, and it gets a better, it's a closer, I feel like it brings it a little closer to the concrete like that, and then I'll finish off with a regular hammer. So anyway, we're done with this, and we're not going to stretch the other room, so this room has been stretched and everything. I helped you put back the furniture in this room. And that was done, and this guy here, and then we saw this room down here where I got most of the carpet off of. So we're all finished up here, so we're done, and it's to take his kids trick-or-treating here. All right, guys, I appreciate you watching another video. Thanks for watching Carpet Time. If you have questions, you're always welcome to text. The number is 512-350-1129. That's Corey Thibodeau in Austin, Texas. And I ask you to please subscribe if you're not subscribed, and please like the video, that helps, and always comment. Anyway, I need 1,000 subscribers, and I'm at 179 right now. Thanks for watching. God bless.